Hello and welcome back to Coding with T. In today's tutorial, we are going to learn how to design product screens. We are going to learn how to design all the products or how to display all the products in a table. So first of all, let's quickly have a look. Okay, we are inside our e-commerce app and we have already created the dashboard, media screen, designed the banners, designed the categories, designed the brands. And today we're going to design the products. And after that, we will design remaining customers, orders and settings screen. So let's go to the products and you can see the products are being loading. And at the top, we have a breadcrumb. Then we have the add product button. And over here, we have a search option. And if we talk about the table, all the products are loaded. And you can see, first of all, the first column contains a product with the sorting option. And we have the image of the product, name of the product in the first column, means we are going to use the row as a first column. Then we have a stock. And also, it can be sorted like this. So if we see the product, we can sort it in the alphanumeric order. So after that, we have the brands over here, all the brands with their logo. After that, we have a price. This is the variable product. So we have a price range, starting price and the ending price. And for a single product, we have a single price over here. After that, we have a date on which this product is created. Currently, it's a dummy date because while adding a model or while adding the data from e-commerce app that we already created, we forget to add the date option. So currently, you can see the static date. After that, we have two action buttons. You can see we have 60 products. So by this way, we can go to next page or the last page. So this is what we are going to create in today's tutorial, because in the next tutorial, I have divided, because this is the in detail design that we are going to learn, or a detailed form to create a product. Because you see, first of all, we are going to create this text field, which is going to cover all the space. And then we're going to learn how to create this type of text field. So we can add as many things as we want. We can add the enter screen. But in this case, let's say I'm going to add and hit the enter. Nothing is going to happen. So this is what we're going to learn, how to add description like this. Then we have the image over here with the add thumbnail button. When we're going to click on this, we will be able to see a pop-up. We can select the banners or the brands or the products. So let's select any one of this. So you can see the image is selected. After that, over here, we have all product images. We will be able to see all the product or the additional images selected over here. Then we have the brand. We can see all the listed brands over here. We can select one brand. And for the categories, we are going to see how we can create this type of pop-up with the checkboxes. And we can select as many categories we want. And by clicking OK, you can see all the selected categories over here. Then we are going to create this option, which is visibility and hidden. And if we talk about the design, you can see this is the line which is dividing the complete row. So first of all, we have a row which is going from left to right side with the two columns in it. The first column contains this side, the second column contains this side. So this is the in-depth tutorial with the single and variable products. If we talk about the single, stock price and discounted price can be added over here, and additionally attributes can be added. For the variable product, you have to first create your attributes, and then all the attributes will be listed over here. By creating generate variations, all the variations will be displayed over here. So this is what we're going to create in next tutorial. And also at the bottom bar, you can see we have discard and save changes option. So let's get started with today's tutorial to design all the products. Okay, we are creating Flutter e-commerce app, and we are inside the second last section in which we are going to, or we are about to complete all the videos. Only 2 to 3 screens left. So after this design, we are going to move to the last section to add the backend functionality. And by this way, you will be able to complete your e-commerce admin panel. If you are new, you can download the complete code. Link is in the description. Also, you can watch the complete playlist of both e-commerce app and the admin panel. I will drop the link in the description, or you can get it from the right top corner. Okay, so let's get started. We are inside our e-commerce app, and over here inside the features, go to the shop feature, and in the screens, I have added a product folder. So in the product, we are not going to work on the create product or the edit product form. So we are going to only target the all products. Inside the same approach, we have a simple static screen which is going to extend with a status widget, and it contains T-site template, desktop, tablet and mobile layouts. All the layouts are inside the responsive screens, all the three screens. All three screens will contain a table, and that table is over here. So we are going to create the table in one place, and then we are going to use that table in all three layouts. Again, you can use single layout over here and remove these two layouts. This widget is automatically going to detect if a tablet and mobile is not available. It is going to apply the desktop for all the layouts. So first of all, let's go to routes. In the routes, we have to add these three screens or the URLs like this: products, create and edit product. Again, if you're new, you can watch the routing and navigation and you can create your own routes. Once we define these three static strings, go to the app routes, and over here we have to copy this and paste it over here, change it to products, and we have to call troutes.products because currently we do not have create product and edit product screen. So let's remove this. And whenever this route is going to be called, we want to redirect screen to product screen, which is this main screen containing all the layouts. So this is the product screen. So let's now talk about the desktop layout. It is again the same layout as we have layouts in all the previous screens. First of all, we have a scaffold, then single child scroll view to scroll the content, spacing from all the sides. Then we have a column, and over here we have a heading or the breadcrumb which we created in the previous tutorials. You can again watch the previous video if you're new. Then we have the TRounded container to create the table body, T table header with the button text as add product, and on press is this one. So if you want to see the breadcrumb headings, this is the widget for the breadcrumbs. It contains breadcrumb trail, default dashboard link, then using loop it is going to create all the routes, and then it has a default heading. And if you want to see the T table header, this is the T table header. It contains two things. The first, it is having an expanded title so that it can be a flexible button inside a row. Then we have expanded text form field, which is on the right side, so that we can search anything. And after that, you can see we have a products table. Then we have the same design for the mobile, same design for the tablet. So now let's talk about the table. First of all, in the products table, we have the columns. In the table source, we have all the rows. For the columns, we have TPaginatedDataTable widget, which we are using, and minimum width is 100 because we have a lot of data over here. So first column is going to be the column of product, in which we're going to display the image and name of the product. It has a fixed width. You can see if the device is the desktop screen, or you can say by this sign, if it is not desktop, then it will be having 300 width, and if it is a desktop, it is going to be a 400. This 300 means either if it is a mobile or it is a tablet, then the product fixed width will be 300, otherwise 400. So then we have a stock, brand, price, date, and action. Action has again fixed width of 100. So all the columns are created. We can create the source or the rows inside the product stream, which is table source dot over here. So open the table source, and in here you can see we are extending this class with the table data source, which is required, means it is going to design rows for us. So we have four override options or the methods. First override is get row. This is going to design the row for us. And then we have the boolean is row count approximate. No, it is false. Row count is currently dummy data, so we have 100 rows. Then we have selected row count, which is 0. So to design the rows, we are going to use data row 2. It should return because the return type of this function is data row. So you have to choose the data row. And inside the cells, we have 5 cells because for each column, we have to design each cell. So in here, let me design the first cell. Let's remove this constant, and I have added a data cell for the first column with a row because we have to add the product image and the product title. So in the row, first thing is TRoundedImage, which is currently containing the static asset and image. It has some space between the image and the title. Make sure to wrap this text with a flexible widget so that it should not crash when the text is going to be larger than its width. Then we have a text, and this is the style. Also make sure to use the overflow as overflow.ellipses or whatever format you like to have. Okay, once this data cell is created, now let's move to the next one. This data cell is only going to create the item count. So it is with a text 256. This is the one I created. Brand, same thing like this one. We have a row. First, we are going to display the brand image, then brand name. It is very same or similar like this. Again, I have to add the overflow. Control Alt L to align. So once the brand is added, we have three more cells. The first cell or the next cell will be the price cell, in which we're going to display the price. Currently it is again a text string. Then we have the date time, and after that we have two action buttons using T table action buttons. They are using a row, and if we want to use the view, edit and delete button, which is the icon buttons, we can use them by making these variables to true and false. By default, edit and delete is true. So we are just going to add on edit pressed and on delete pressed. So currently on delete pressed is not going to do anything, but when this on edit press is going to be called, we will redirect to the on edit press screen or the edit screen. Currently we do not have that screen, but by this way we are ended with our design. So let's save it or run it. Okay, our application is running, and we forgot to add the products inside the sidebar. So let's go to common widgets, and in the layouts, sidebar.dart, over here let's add Control D to duplicate, change the banners to products, icon to shopping bag, and item name to products. Let's save it. And now you can see after banners we have the product. So all these three screens are created. Now it's time for the products. Click on it and you can see the table is appeared. We have the add product, we have a search bar. Currently we cannot see the image because we do not have the image in the assets. So we have the image, we have a title, we have a stock, we have the brand, price, date and action buttons. So page not found is the error because we do not have that page. So let's go back. Once this edit screen is created, we will see the edit page over here. And same way, when we are going to click on add product, the page not found is the page. Currently it's not designed, but you can design this page as well if you want. So this is what we wanted to create. If you want to see the responsiveness, currently it is in the tablet mode, and let's reduce it a bit further. And you can see the date is adjusting itself. And we can reduce it a bit further. And currently we are inside the mobile screen, and this is the design that is going to look like in the mobile. Down below you can see we have a scroll bar which can scroll the content. So this is what we wanted to create. Okay, so once again thank you for watching, and in the next tutorial we're going to work on the add products and the create product form, and after that almost we will be done with our design. And once again, if you want to download the complete code, link is in the description, and you can also watch the playlist of e-commerce app and admin panel. Both link will be in the description. Thank you for watching and take care.